Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about practicing for the STAR assessment. If you go to your ClassLink account, you're going to look for the TEA interim assessment. Go ahead and click on it. It'll bring up the screen, and over on the right, we're going to choose practice. Then take the test. We're going to select a year. Now, it's your choice to select any year you'd like to try. I'm going to try 2016, but it's important that we choose our grade level, which is grade 3, and the subject we're practicing today is mathematics. And we're going to put select, take the SOA grade 3 mathematics, and then take test. So here it walks you through a couple of the things where you can speak. The brown fox jumps over the lazy white dog. And if you can hear it, you're going to hit yes. We'll hit next. Read that through. Those are the directions for the test. Hit next. It talks to you how you're moving through the test and see the questions we're on. That's located at the bottom of the screen. Again, more about moving through the test, the tools available to us, and that's what we're focusing on today, the tools that will be available to us. Now, when we get to a stop screen, normally when we're taking a test, we always stop here and wait for the teacher to tell us to proceed. But as we're doing just this practice test, go ahead and hit next. Now, I'll have my scratch paper next to me so that I know which test I'm taking and the question here that I'm working on is number one. Remember, I want us to show all of our work here on the paper, but the STAR assessment also has some really neat tools to help us practice. For example, let's read the question. Anissa shaded part of the figure shown below. What fraction of the figure is shaded? Now, I know it's asking me for a fraction, so I could go ahead and highlight that word fraction by clicking my mouse, click highlight, and now it's noticed it's in yellow, and it wants me to find the shaded portion, which I also know that's important. Now, I know I'm finding a fraction of just the shaded portion. Now, up here, there's a really cool tool, and it allows us to choose the pencil. So I'm going to click on the pencil and I'm going to choose red. Now, a really great thing here with this shape, I can count all of the pieces knowing that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now remember, the denominator is always on the bottom. That's how many total pieces make up the whole, and I can write 8. Now I want to count the numerator, and that's where I just count the shaded portion. So I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I know I have 6, which is my numerator, that's on the top. So 6/8 is the fraction I'm looking for. Thanks to this really nifty pencil tool, I now can go ahead and look, which one doesn't have 6/8? Wow, there's a cool eliminator tool that X's out any choices. I'm going to select it. If it doesn't say 6/8, I can automatically remove it. Look, there's just one answer choice left. So now it's as simple as that. I'm going to choose 6/8. This way, I've shown all of my work. Let's try one more. Now, this question says the members of the gym use 98 towels. I'm going to put every day. That's pretty important, so I'm going to highlight it. How many tools are used in 7 days? Again, I think that's important as well. Now, let's say I want to talk and I wanted to get out graph paper. Maybe that's going to help me on this one. So for example, if I wanted to color in my shaded parts, I could choose different parts on the graph paper. When I'm done, just exit out. All right, I hope you had fun learning about the tools for the STAR interim assessment. Talk to you later.